Hi, I'm Andy Farke. I'm a dinosaur paleontologist at the Raymond M. Alf Museum of Paleontology at the Webb Schools.
Hello, my name is Mairin Balisi. I am a mammal paleontologist specializing in fossil carnivores, and I'm the curator of paleontology here at the Alf Museum at the Webb Schools.
Yeah. And we are super excited. This is for each of us the first time to watch through the official trailer for 65. So let's see what happens here. Oh, wow. Just another day at work.
Another crash landing.
No dinosaurs yet. Oh, asteroids. Okay, space is good. Cool. All right. Just an average day. Cool. No dinosaurs yet.
There's too much mammal in this at the moment.
I mean, if you're going to have any mammals, Adam Driver's a good one.
No comment. Braun.
Okay, yeah, yep, okay. Ooh. Looking for dinosaurs. Where are the dinosaurs? I was promised dinosaurs. Not a dinosaur. Maybe it is. It's a water dinosaur.
Another mammal.
Yep, more mammals. Those are plants, not mammals. Oh, breathable atmosphere. Excellent. Good. Oh, wow. Okay, there we go. What's happening? More mammal. Do we get a jump scare? Please let's. Oh, 65. Okay. All right. Okay, we got to pause it here. This is going to be our first well actually moment. What do you want to say?
Well, actually, it wasn't 65 million years ago.
If there's dinosaurs. Unless we're using like the old geological time scale, in which case I guess it's totally acceptable. I will say, like, in our museum we have on our placards for the Mesozoic, it does say 65 million years ago, but that's because the dates get rejiggled a little bit as there's new, like, better radiometric dating of some of these boundaries. So we'll just, like, suspend disbelief. If there's dinosaurs, we'll just say this is, like, the pre-2012 timescale, 28, whatever year. Okay, cool. More dinosaurs. Let's find some dinosaurs. Dinosaurs? No dinosaurs. Oh, look.
Oh.
I think that was a dinosaur. Oh, they're in prehistoric Earth. Okay, here we go. Oh, they're shooting at a theropod. Okay.
Feathers?
Are there no feathers? I don't know. The thing I love about this is, given the discourse I've seen on this online, I'm going to back up just a little bit. There's like really no way like any comment we make is going to win. I think that's the most fun is this, like, everything I've read is like people are polarized one way or the other. So, but there's a dinosaur. Mm-hmm. It's been very theropod heavy, which I guess is okay. Oh, there's our little dromaeosaur raptor type thing. Okay. Wow, okay. All right. Oh, that's a dinosaur eating a robot. That's cool. Okay, 65. All right. Wow. Okay. Yeah.
Well, I think this solves a long-standing scientific mystery of what killed the dinosaurs.
Which was?
Adam Driver was the asteroid.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I like this. Yeah. Maybe the real asteroid was the friends we made along the way.
Yeah,
I don't know.
Yeah. I think so.
Yeah. Cool. I mean, it's interesting. For all the hype I've seen about it online, I was expecting more dinosaurs, just given like how much everyone was riled up. I mean, sure, this looks like it'll be a good popcorn flick. I don't have any strong comments. I guess maybe I feel bad about this. I should have stronger feelings.
I mean, do you want to go into the 65 number a little bit more?
Sure,
Since, you know, 65 million years ago, I mean, technically, if we're going by the newer timescale, dinosaurs that were not birds should have gone extinct. Mm-hmm. And so we, like, I think it's accurate in that there were mammals, not Adam Driver, but there were other mammals on the landscape at this time that had started, you know, proliferating after mm-hmm. the dinosaur extinctions. Mm-hmm. But yeah, what other thoughts?
Yeah, I mean, I think I think there's going to open up a whole bunch of conversations about how we get the geological time scale. Mm-hmm. And I'm not a huge fan of, well, actually modes of scientific communication of just like correcting misfacts. Like that's not terribly engaging or informative and it's really not the point. But yeah, I think it'll open up some interesting, at least it's going to be the pop cultural reference of the moment mm-hmm. For us when we want to connect with the youth of our generation. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah, 1 million years difference is like mm-hmm. such a big deal. It's yeah. just totally outside of, you know, the scale of human timelines.
Yeah. So. It'll be interesting. I think this yeah. It's one of those popcorn films yeah. and I'm not going to mm-hmm. go there for the science.
Yeah.
But that's okay.
Yeah. One thing that I did hear about from other paleos is, you know, discussion about feathers or not on this theropod, but based on this one, you know, like picture, it looks like there's some fuzz on that head. I don't know if that would be.
It could be, and yeah, if it has feathers or not, it's a movie. So
yeah,
off we go. All right, cool. Well, that was fun.
That was fun.
And we'll have to see what the next trailers look like.
Yeah. All right. I'm looking forward to the movie. Yeah.
This was fun. All right. We'll see y'all later. Bye.